Hi Capricorn, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your life purpose and career reading for October, November, December 2016. I'm drawing three cards from the Archangel Power Tarot, three cards from the Life Purpose Oracle deck, and one card from the Ascended Masters Oracle deck, looking at the energies around your life purpose and career for this time period. And I go ahead and pull your cards, Capricorn. I have already shuffled all the decks. And I'm just reminding all signs, as you well know, Capricorn, that your life purpose is never something that you have to seek outside of yourself. It is always found within. And as you begin to just have more consciousness around this, and around the thoughts that you think, the emotions that you feel, the words that you say, you can begin to live your life purpose in each and every moment, which just expands upon itself and amplifies until suddenly you're living every minute, every hour, every day, every week, every month, etc., with a sense of purpose and fulfillment. And it kind of works like that. So it's super fun when you kind of look at it like this and remember it in this way. And of course, you know, I know you know this already, but it's just a gentle reminder, because as we go through our days, it's easy to forget this as that's the truth. So Capricorn, let me go ahead and just pull the cards for you. Capricorn. Life purpose. October, November. And career. October, November, December 2016. Okay. Three of Ariel just pulled out. Nine of Raphael, Ten of Ariel. Very nice energies for you. I'll show you Capricorn. We have the Three of Ariel, we have the Nine of Raphael. Can you see it? And the Ten of Ariel. I keep getting the word tinkering with this. Like, I feel like you're tinkering with things right now. Fine-tuning. Playing a little bit. What it is you want to do. Energy healing card just popped right up. There we go. Okay. The artist card just flipped right up. And we have Heart's Desires. Gosh. I think Sagittarius just got this. I think Virgo might have got this. Okay, I'll show you how I see the cards, Capricorn. I'm getting excited for your reading here. Okay, so we have the energy healing. We have the artist right in the center. And we have your Heart's Desires right there. So many different ways that this can come in for you. So it is a general reading. Let me just go ahead and get one more card for you, and then I'll do the reading. It's going to be an intuitive reading, so the text of the cards is helpful, but not the only information here. Yeah, I feel like you've been tinkering, and you want to get it right. It's kind of what it's feeling like for me. Just to remind you, Capricorn, that you cannot do it wrong. That everything that you do is for you, for your growth, for your expansion. So just remember that. Nope. Thought I had it. Listen.
Manjushri. I'm just learning these ascended masters, so excuse me if I say it incorrectly.
Manjushri, I think, is how you say it. Probably not, though. But I can certainly say listen, and I can give you that message. Listening to your inner guidance. Tinkering. Some of you are going to Paris. I just have to say, it's coming through. I'm really, you know, this is the Eiffel Tower in the background here, and but it's like really, like kind of energetically, like waving at me. So I have to say that to you. Okay, Capricorn, give me a minute. I have to take in all these energies for you. Okay, so I'm going to start with the Life Purpose Oracle deck here. And let's just talk about this because it's really exciting. So for some of you, you are indeed involved in energy healing already. It kind of feels like it's kind of a little bit more towards the beginning or the past kind of October energy. And it's been extremely beneficial for you. It's like something you've enjoyed. For some of you, this energy healing card is an indication that receiving some sort of energy healing work would help you align with your sense of purpose, right? Your natural healing abilities are an important part of your life purpose. So for some of you, this is true. And if you haven't already begun to explore it, but have always been interested in it, then this is kind of a little nudge from your guides and angels here, Capricorn. And then right here in the center, we have this artist card. And then as we move forward, towards the end of the year and into 2017, we have your heart's desires. The angels are supporting, guiding, and protecting you as your dreams become reality. Really, really lovely energy. I'm going to get to that in a second here. And I want to focus here on this artist card. Engaging in artistic activities is beneficial to your career and every other area of your life. This has a lot of meanings. For some of you, of course, it means that you have... you are an artist, and if you haven't already begun to pursue it, it's strongly indicated here. But I'm really drawn to this tinkering, this idea of tinkering, of playing, kind of fine-tuning what you like to do, spending some time in quiet solitude, like quiet meditation kind of energy as you tinker, as you play. Even with the painting, the image I'm getting is just very sort of small movements, just kind of playing, very sort of meditative kind of feeling with it. And even with this Three of Ariel, this idea of this, here's this man is in his workshop and he's tinkering with everything and he's very content and is opening up his heart. I feel like this music box is opening up his heart to himself. He's revealing his heart to himself. He's warming his heart. It feels very warm and kind of loving, quiet energy for him as he's tinkering. Even here, he's opening up his passion. Right? It's as his heart opens and he begins to listen to the music of his own heart, he begins to listen, as I mentioned, to the music of his own heart. This other box is opening right here. I don't know if you can see it. It's like he's opening up his passionate nature. He's opening up his lower chakras here. And it's going right into him. It also goes with energy healing, right? Feel the energy going into him as you look at that card, Capricorn. It goes back to the energy healing. Receiving energy healing would be really, really beneficial for you if you've never done it or if you've only played with it. And for some of you who are an energy healer, it's just part of your power. Even if you aren't actually earning money at it, it could just be that you are a natural hugger. You know how some people, you hug them and you just melt into them? Some people just have that, right? And that could be part of your purpose, is just to spread that love in the way that you do, right? It's very, very warm energy. So it's going to be different for everybody. It says, do what you love. The Three of Ariel card here. Do what you love. A time of great personal growth in your career or artistic endeavors. Working with others in a cooperative manner. And I feel like, yeah, that's true, but there's also this sense of being alone here as well. Just this idea of tinkering, just spending some time tinkering. It really will open up your heart and kind of be more meditative, because I think, and I don't feel a lot of noise there. It really, for me, this listen is really not about listening to others. It's just about listening to the music of your own heart, listening to the tick, the TikTok, you know, that goes on. It's very rhythmic, meditative kind of sounds that I'm kind of hearing in my head. And that will help you tremendously because we have this Nine of Raphael energy, and beneath it we have the artist. And the Nine of Raphael is the dream, the wishes coming true kind of card here. You know, the genie in the bottle, like making a wish. So as you begin to tinker, as you begin to do these meditative, creative exercises, in whatever way that works for you, again, it's a general reading, you will begin to manifest your dreams, your heart's desires, right here. Having these two cards right here in a reading is so, so fun and exciting. It says, make a wish, dreams become reality, a joyful time of life. And I think there's a little bit of a twist here for you, Capricorn. It's like almost like you want to tinker and you want to give. You want to give. And right now, it's about, see how much he's like handing that bottle, right? Or whatever it is, to someone. But I feel like for you, take a pause, Capricorn, because before you give away your power, make sure you are getting your dreams true first. Like, you know, it's if it's not a blessing for you, Capricorn, then it's not a blessing for anyone. And this is kind of the message here. Like, listen to that, because it's really important that you understand and begin to incorporate more self-care so that, and I know you do this already, it's just a deepening of that during this time period, so that when your dreams come true, they're for you first. And when you feel fulfilled, when you feel that your heart is open and receptive and receiving the blessings of the universe, then you're more filled up and you can give to another, right? And then we have this sense of completion here with the Ten of Ariel, this sense of generations happy, more financial security going on. It says, there is so much to be grateful for, financial success and the promise of retirement, a rich and rewarding family life. And I'm really drawn to the fact that it says cafe day something, right? We don't know what yet. And that could be for many of you who are entering, again, it's this kind of the 10 energy is about completion and the new beginnings as we enter into the new year. And so it's like, what cafe what? Like, what is the cafe you're at? Where are you going to be? What are you going to be doing? The reason we have that is because we have that sense of completion here. Again, for some of you, there will be travel to Paris. Just that Eiffel Tower is just like waving at me. So there's some lovely energy for you here, and to have this sense of, you know, stability and completion and financial rewards with the heart's desires as you're kind of going into 2017. It's really, really lovely energy for you. I'm going to get three more cards for you, Capricorn, just looking at the heart's desires and the kind of also clarifying the Ten of Ariel here and see if I can get a bit more information for you. Again, this idea of tinkering, of coming back to self, fine-tuning what it is you want, allowing yourself a little bit of play. It will all help loosen up the energies around you and help you expand more into your sense of fulfillment. And for some of you, it does indicate that there is a career for you in some sort of artistic field. I also am getting engineering your life. Like, you want to engineer your life in the way that works best for you as opposed to what works for others. Drawn to the fact that this guy kind of seems like he might be an engineer of some sort. For some of you, it does mean that you were an engineer, kind of, or you are, kind of in the past here, and you're getting more and more in touch with the more etheric side of our existence here, less about the mechanical side. Beginning to understand energies more. Okay, so the Knight of Gabriel flew out, and this is clarifying the Ten of Ariel and the Heart's Desires energy. We have the Emperor energy, beautiful, strong energy of structure and logic and creating something for the future here. And the Knight of Gabriel is very much about taking action. You know, he's a very fast-moving knight. time to take action, great passion for a cause, instinctively knowing just what to do. Your heart's desire, as you make your wishes, you know, and you tinker and you play here a little bit and you listen to your inner voice, to the music of your own heart, you begin to approach this sense of completion and stability and contentment. You know, your heart's desire is coming true, and then clarifying this all of this sort of completion energy and your heart full and everything coming true. We have this fast-moving night, you know, taking action upon what you're called to do. We have the Emperor. You're also creating structure around it. And then we have this need for a little bit of patience. Like, you're laying the seeds for 2017 here. And so just have some patience as you kind of go into 17. There's a lot of forward momentum with this night energy, but it kind of feels like that's what you've been doing, and you've created some structure. And then you want to allow time to know what to fill the structure with. Like, you bought the new home kind of thing. And then, okay, now how do I want to decorate it? And what little pieces? Again, tinkering, this idea of tinkering and fine-tuning is very present here for you. And then the Seven of Ariel, again, like, have some patience because you've laid the foundations. Like, the Emperor's about laying the foundations, creating that structure. It says you have invested wisely. Again, it could refer to money as well here for you. Have patience and wait for the harvest. Review your progress and make plans for your next endeavor. So as you go into 2017, Capricorn, some really lovely energies here for you. I think I want to get, I'm going to get from the Life Changes Oracle deck just because we have this sense of completion as we go into 2017 here. And again, and I say it as kind of more towards the future with this energy here, the Ten of Ariel and the Heart's Desires. But these energies are going to be prevalent throughout this whole time period. They're just going to play out a little differently for everybody in terms of time frame. And remember that energy healing, is important for you. It's been an important part of for some of you, it's been an important part of what you've been doing. And for some of you, it's going to help clarify things for you if you can get some energy healing in. And then we have the Family Changes card. It goes with a sense of completion here, retirement, changes within the family structure, divorces, marriages, all of that change, you know, children leaving, children coming back in, elderly family members needing care, you know, all of that comes under this purview here of family changes. But whatever it is, I feel like you've created some really nice structure that's going to help you with these family changes, regardless of whether you're experiencing them as sort of more positive or a little less invited kind of energy, let's say. But you absolutely can handle it, and you've laid the foundation to support it, because I'm really drawn to this sort of red strong color and the orange here, and you've created something powerful with that Emperor energy there. And so the family changes, I think, are going to be beneficial in a lot of ways, or they're certainly not going to be anything that rocks you in a way that feels as if your life is crumbling, anything like that. So it feels like it's, you know, what we would consider more positive type of energy for you, Capricorn. Wow, there's a lot going on for you guys. So anyway, I hope you find that helpful, and always, always trust your own intuition above and beyond anything I say or anyone else. And you're going to have your own sense of what these cards mean for you, of course, because it is a general reading. So trust your own intuition. All right, I hope you find that helpful. I wish you much love as always, and I will see you on the next video or at your private reading.